I'm Iahn Gonsenhauser, Chief Quality and Patient Safety Officer at The Ohio State University Wexner Medical Center. Vaccines are one of the miracles of modern medicine and science. Over the years, we've eradicated diseases like polio and smallpox due to vaccine technology. Now that we have two viable and approved vaccines for COVID-19, we're beginning to see the light at the end of the tunnel. These vaccines are over 90% effective and have tremendous safety profiles, thus far well tolerated for hundreds of thousands of patients who have received the vaccine. With the availability of these new vaccines, there are a few things you should know. Number one, while this is newer technology, the technology has been around for a while, and it's been tested and proven safe and effective. Number two, for both of the available vaccines currently, both Pfizer and Moderna, you should expect to receive two doses of vaccine, your initial dose and a booster dose 3 to 4 weeks later. Number three, many people are asking if you've previously been exposed or tested positive for COVID-19, should you still receive a vaccine? Right now, the answer to that question is yes. There is evidence that suggests the immunity derived from vaccination is actually better and potentially stronger than the immunity derived from natural exposure to COVID-19. So at present, anybody, even if you've been previously exposed to COVID-19 or tested positive, is eligible for the vaccine. Some people have asked if they can avoid getting the vaccine and simply stick to masking and physical distancing. While masks and physical distancing have been the mainstay of our approach to mitigating the risk of COVID-19 at this point, with a vaccine that is 90 to 95% effective, that really is the strongest protection you can offer yourself and those around you. And while continuing to use your masks and distancing is critical, it shouldn't be a replacement for considering getting the vaccine. It's going to take a number of months before we've vaccinated enough of the population to begin to return to normal. Until then, please continue to focus on our mitigation strategies of mask use, hand hygiene, and physical distancing. With two safe and highly effective vaccines, we can finally see the light at the end of the tunnel. Let's continue to move forward towards the end of the pandemic with care, not fear.